mill started way back in 1968. Danny Federici and I, at that time, were playing in a band with a guy named Billy Chinnick, who has long moved past now. But when that band broke up, we wanted to still play together, and we were looking for guitar players and bass players and such. And I ran into Bruce at an Italian-American club in Long Branch, New Jersey. And you know, I said, hey, Jam would have come down. Jam would have set the Upstage Club, which was in Asbury Park. And then about a month later, Danny and I walked in the Upstage, and there was Bruce playing with little Vinnie Roslin and big Bobby Williams on drums. And you could just tell right then, this is the guy. So we went up to him after their set and said, hey, let's jam. You know, he goes, okay, yeah. So we got special permission from Tom Potter to play, and we jammed away for about an hour and did a bunch of stuff. Went down in the Green Mermaid Coffee House and said, hey, let's make a band. So we did, and it became Child, which then became Steel Mill. The guys in that band that went on to the E Street Band, Bruce, of course, myself, Danny Federici, and after Little Vinny left the band, we had Steve Van Zandt playing bass for a while. So that was actually the nucleus of what was going on, yes. Bruce went off on his own, went out to California to see his parents, and we all kind of went our separate ways. I worked in a boatyard. I don't know what the other fellows were doing, really, but I got a call from Bruce one day. And he says, hey, you want to make a record? It reminded me of my friend Buzzy Lipinski. You want to make a record? And I said, sure, let's do it. So we rehearsed for about a week, and we went up and cut the first album. We weren't the E Street Band still. Then when we started doing the second album, we were still on the road. Davey Sanchez got in the band. He lived on E Street in Belmont. And somehow it just stuck. But I don't think the name's on too many albums in the beginning, you know, E Street Band, but we certainly were.
It all started with the, first off, I have a physics degree, and when we were doing the steel mill thing, Federici walked up one day and said, we need a PA. So I started building audio equipment. Danny would sort of make sure that he liked it a certain way, and the band liked it, and when they liked it, I was happy. And I just, the things just started to roll, and we got some really good gigs. We started playing down the hill from the shop at Pandemonium. And from there, it just grew because of the material, and the execution was just great. And so I became a sound engineer, manager, truck driver, whatever the hell you want to call it, for a couple of years. And it got big. We made a lot of money. For that time, we were making a lot of money playing one or two nights a month. And it just got bigger and better.
Seaweed strands, so smiling, they heard the fishes of the deep, and ride for you and me. They ranched the ridge and the sunken soil at the bottom of the sea. And in the dead of night, alive in sleep, I can hear them calling me. Those deep sea desperados, those cowboys of the sea. Yeah. On wings asleep, I pierce the deep and ride like a hurricane.